Good evening, everyone. I am Bill Trigg, CEO of Make-A-Wish Northeast New York, and I am proud to welcome you to our official kickoff of the 28th annual Adopt-A-Wish holiday campaign. We are excited to have you join us tonight from near and far as we launch this iconic campaign. We will share with you tonight how you can keep hope burning bright for local children and teens battling critical illnesses, especially right now. Because wishes are waiting and hope is essential. Joining me to share this message with you is J.R. George, Administrative Vice President of Trustco Bank, our presenting sponsor of the campaign. J.R., thank you for being here with us tonight and for Trustco's support of the campaign over the last 5 years.
Thank you, Bill. This is certainly a change to our usual kickoff celebration at Crossgates, but this event is a further example of how much our world has changed and adjusted due to the current pandemic. And that change has hit Make-A-Wish in a profound ways. The Adopt-A-Wish holiday campaign is the single most important fundraising and public awareness campaign of the year for Make-A-Wish Northeast New York. The donations made to this campaign last year granted, in whole or in part, more than 20 wishes. These funds are the foundation of the wish granting efforts and are vital to helping achieve the vision of granting the wish of every eligible child in the chapter.
COVID-19 has forced Make-A-Wish as an enterprise across the country to rethink how wishes are granted and has made raising the necessary funds a daunting task, which is why we're doing things differently, including hosting this virtual kickoff. This evening, together, we launched the 2020 Adopt-A-Wish holiday campaign with renewed dedication to our Wish Kids and an ambitious goal to raise $175,000 during the next 6 weeks to fund 14 to 15 wishes. We cannot do this without the support of our community and all of you who are participating. This campaign would not be possible without the help of our many sponsors, including, as mentioned previously, our presenting sponsor, Trustco Bank, also our Wish Champion sponsor, NYSCOBA, and the more than 30,000 correctional officers they represent throughout the state, as well as the Pharmaceutical Research and Manufacturers of America, Glens Falls National Bank, and the Albany Police Athletic League.
Throughout the campaign, we invite you to donate at our Trustco Bank branches throughout the Capital Region, area malls, and local schools and businesses. But we're also challenging individuals to become wish heroes, to share their Make-A-Wish experience and champion wishes by raising funds from their families, friends, and peers. Stars will also be available online on the campaign website at aawc.givesmart.com. We also hope you'll join us on December 3rd for the Day of Wishes Telethon with help from our media partners, WRGB, CBS6, and B95.5.
Since early March, an 8.5 month span when we would typically have granted 40 to 50 wishes, we've only been able to grant 14 wishes. But we aren't going to dwell on what we can or not have not been able to do. We are focused on what we can do. We're focused on having creative conversations to help our wish kids determine several possible wishes that are true, innovative, and heartfelt and meaningful to them. We're looking at also innovative ways to continue engaging wish kids that are waiting for a time when it is safe to travel for their wishes again. We're working with chapters across the country to determine how we can grant wishes more effectively. We're looking ahead and looking at a pipeline of kids that continues to grow, because the battles these kids face has not stopped or pause for the coronavirus. We know our task is difficult, but at Make-A-Wish, we know how to look forward. We know how to dream big, and we know how to work together to make magic happen. One final note before we move on. We want to thank our partners at Crossgates Mall, Colony Center, Wilton Mall, Aviation Mall, and Champlain Center for hosting again, hosting us again this year. We know our mall partners are taking extraordinary measures to keep patrons and our volunteers safe as the pandemic continues. We are working closely with them as they work closely with the Department of Health. We're being flexible and adjusting the campaign as needed to do our best for the safety of our volunteers and our generous donors. Thank you for continuing to support them and to support our mission. Now, we want to share a video that introduces our 2020 Adopt-A-Wish campaign ambassadors. These Wish kids have already experienced the life-changing power of a wish, and now they are looking ahead and paying it forward to the many Wish kids out there waiting for their wishes to come true.
My make-a-wish was going to Florida to meet the Red Sox.
My wish was to go on Halloween to Disney.
Disney?
Disney!
My wish was to go to Los Angeles, California.
Teek's wish was to go to a handicapped amusement park, which was located in San Antonio, Texas, called Morgan's Playland.
My wish was seeing a unicorn.
I've been so much thankful for Make-A-Wish. It's an amazing thing, and I couldn't say anything else than thank you.
It was end of a long year and a half of treatment, so we really needed that trip just for our own bonding time together. We've been separated a lot, you know, during the treatment, so it was a nice time for us, the four of us, to get away together, and we just had a ball. Swam and ate ice cream and went to Disney and saw Ariel and all the princesses.
Elsa and Anna.
It's an incredible opportunity to, after everything that they've been through, to be granted a wish like this. It's truly an amazing experience. Make-A-Wish is awesome, and it really changed our lives tremendously.
The people from Make-A-Wish were amazing. They were there for any little thing we needed. We didn't have to worry about food, drink, shelter. It was just a time for us to enjoy our family. And he really had like the time of his life. He never stopped smiling the whole time we were there. We had a great time. It was wonderful. And the whole experience itself. But I mean, I would have never been able to afford a trip like that.
Thank you so much for donating so that sick kids could have happy moments.
Anything is possible. Just think your wish through carefully. Think about what you want to do and go through it.
Wishes are waiting.
Hope is essential.
Donate today.
All right. Good evening, everybody. We'll continue with the program tonight. My name is Alyssa Carapriest, and I am the morning meteorologist for CBS6. So happy to be working with Make-A-Wish again this year. That video turned out great. It's kind of weird because normally by now I'm familiar with all the ambassadors, but 2020 has thrown us for a loop. So this is my first time getting to meet them, and definitely looking forward to meeting the kids tonight and hearing about their wishes. Chad.
I feel the same. Chad O'Hara from B95.5, program director and music director and morning show host. And I feel the same way. It is tough this year being not connected as we usually are, but we're connecting in different ways. It's being creative for 2020 is basically what we're doing. I do want to meet the kids as well. So let's make sure we do that.
Yeah. All right, so we'll jump into it. Just want to first start off by saying myself and CBS6, honored to partner up with Make-A-Wish again this year. We seem to be with them every year now and always look forward to this event. More important than ever because wishes are waiting and hope is essential. You heard Bill saying that tonight. We're excited to give all of you watching the opportunity to hear from our 2020 Wish Ambassadors. They're joining us tonight from all over our area. We do have a couple of ambassadors from the North Country with us tonight. So thank you to all of them for joining us and thank you to their families. And now we're going to jump into meeting all of them.
And as you can see, they're coming on the screen. As we get set up, you can see them getting, just give us a moment or two. There we go. Hey, Mackenzie. Hey, guys, everybody's starting to, well, you know, get, here we go. Megan. Tyler. Evan, what's up, buddy?
Hi, how are you?
All right. I think we're seeing most of our Wish ambassadors pop up right now. I think we're just waiting for one more. But as you can see, it's a big party tonight. We're very excited about it. And we have our Wish ambassadors to introduce to you. We have Aubrey, who's 14. Her wish was to go to Paris Fashion Week. We have Elijah, 6, whose wish was to go to Morgan's Wonderland. Evan's wish, my wish too, buddy, to meet the Boston Red Sox at the spring training camp. So good wish. Also, Jaden, who's 16, wish was to go to Los Angeles, California. Lainey, 9 years old, her wish was to go to Walt Disney World Resort for Halloween. How cool, I'm dressed up already. Also, we have Madison, who is 4, wish was to go to Walt Disney World Resort. And also Sydney was a wish to go to Walt Disney World Resort as well. And Tyler's wish was to meet the undefeated Pittsburgh Steelers. So, hey, everybody.
All right. I think that's everyone. Do we have everyone waiting on Sydney, I think?
Yes.
But I think we'll start off and start introducing our ambassadors and getting you familiar with them. So Tyler, you're up first, buddy. You met the Pittsburgh Steelers. Tell us what that was like, meeting the players and the staff. How was it?
Oh, that was awesome. I didn't even know I was going to meet the Steelers. My wish was just to go watch a game, and that's what I heard. And then we got there, and they said, all right, we're going to, your limo's here. I was like, wait, what? Because yeah, you're going to meet the players. So I was like, awesome. So they drove us to the practice field to do that. And then I got there, I got there a bit earlier than the practice ended. So I got to watch them practice too, which was pretty cool because I never saw that. So I got to see how they worked during practice, which was pretty good. And then afterwards the team lined up and Tomlin was ahead of them and he turned around. He gave me a thumbs up. I was like, yeah. And he sent them all my way.
Wait, so did you meet a bunch of players or was it just a couple or how was that?
No, the only ones we get to meet were Ben because he was out on his injury and mm-hmm. the kicker, but the rest of them I got to meet. I got a signed pair of cleats from Juju. The team signed a ball and a little signed helmet with as many signatures as I could fit on it.
Wow. Sounds like a dream come true. What was the best part of your wish?
Definitely getting the signed cleats and then actually seeing the game, being in the stadium during the game was the energy in there was enormous. It was like the I can't even describe it. Like the feeling you got when everybody just stood up and just started screaming was awesome.
Yeah. Very
and then
cool.
I got to meet the game too. So I ended up getting a picture with him. We tried to get on the Jumbotron by acting like a fools as much as we could, but one thing.
That's awesome. Just hearing you talk about it, you can tell how much of a fun experience, something that you'll just remember forever, I bet. I'm sure you have more to go to some Steelers games in the future.
Oh, yeah. I plan to become a season ticket holder.
Awesome. Awesome. All right, Tyler, thanks so much. Again, Tyler's 18, and he is joining us from the North Country, right, Tyler?
Yep. Basically, as much I'm like as far north as you can get in your state. So
Very cool. All right, we're going to move on to Madison. Madison's wish was to go to Walt Disney World. Madison, who did you see when you were there?
Elsa.
Elsa?
Who else?
Mickey.
You can speak up.
Mickey.
Mickey? Oh my gosh, I bet that was so fun. I bet you met a bunch of characters while you were there.
Yes, lots of them. Who else?
Minnie.
And was there any others? All the Star Wars, Chewie, Chewbacca.
So Mom, what was this like, having this wish granted for Madison? What was it like for you seeing her happy, her family to get away and kind of get a break from everything?
Vampirina.
Oh, Vampirina we saw too. It gave our family a sense of, you know, hope and promise that, you know, everything that she had been through, that, you know, everything is going to be okay. Mm-hmm. It was a great opportunity. It brought us all together after not being, you know, together all the time and back and forth between the hospital and doctors and things like that. It just gave us really just that hope that, you know, we're going to get through this and everything is going to be okay.
Yeah. I bet you noticed a big boost in her mood too.
Yes. Yes. She loved it. Lots of memories. We still talk about it to this day. So.
Awesome. Love that. All right, well, Tyler and Madison and Mom, thank you so much. We're going to continue tonight, and I'll send it over to Chad now to meet a couple more of our ambassadors.
Thank you, Alyssa. It's a great pleasure to introduce this guy, 14 years old from Brunswick, big Sox fan, Boston Red Sox fan, and his wish was to go to Boston Red Sox training camp. Me being a fan, I know that he went, Evan, you went after the 2018 championship, right?
Actually, no, it was 2 years ago.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, because the Washington won first after that. So,
well, tell me about the experience, because you got a chance to go and see your favorite players in Florida.
Yeah, I really love my wish, but the only thing was, the Red Sox had a very bad trade, and you know this already. everything was crazy through the Red Sox, meeting all the people, especially talking to Jackie Bradley, which I liked him when he was in South Carolina. Mm-hmm. And he signed my jersey, and then he's like, "Hey, can you hold my bat?" Signs my jersey, gets a picture, and then he's like, "That bat is for you." I'm like, "Excuse me?"
And I saw the photo of you and your family. That's what really stuck out was, I saw the smile on your face, buddy, but I could see the smile on your parents' face, which I knew meant a lot for the entire family, which is why these wishes are so important. Obviously, you got to, you know, be Jackie Bradley's bat boy, but your family.
Pretty much, but I didn't have to run.
Right.
That's the only difference.
It's something that the whole family will remember forever.
So definitely.
What would you say to other kids, Evan, who are have wishes in waiting?
Just, yes, Corona's has done a lot, but Make-A-Wish is such a great thing, and just wait until when it's going to be even better, what you're thinking when it actually comes back.
You know, that's such a positive statement, Evan. And coming from you, that means an awful lot. I thank you for sharing that, buddy. And go Sox!
Yeah, go Sox.
We're introducing another Wish ambassador to you. I have the pleasure to introduce to you Lainey, 9 years old from Latham. Hi, Lainey. You've been excited ever since you got on. I saw your smile as soon as you got here, and you had such a great wish because I know a lot of people think about going to Walt Disney World, but you wanted to go to Walt Disney World for Halloween. So explain that.
I wanted to go to Walt Disney World in Halloween time because I really wanted to go to the Mickey's Halloween party. I wanted to go there because of all of the costumes and how funny.
I could just imagine all the costumes, especially Disney does everything up. So I'm sure it was just a magical experience and, you know, like a magical Halloween experience, which is even cooler.
Yeah.
So how did your trip make you feel? Like, how did you feel after taking that trip?
I felt very grateful because I wouldn't have been able to go there at that time.
Did you just feel like more of a kid? Like, finally, you didn't have to deal with some treatments and you didn't have to deal with some things. You could just be yourself and actually dress up and have a great time.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the best part. So your family enjoyed it too, I bet.
Yeah.
Well, Lainey, thanks for sharing your story. And these are just some of the stories. Alyssa will tell you some more of our Wish ambassadors, but this is truly the power of a wish. And we thank you for being a part of it.
All right, we're going to keep on moving, and we're going to try and touch base with Sydney. Sydney, I'm going to ask, though, if you can start your video so that we can see you, because right now we can't, and unmute your mic. We'll see if we can get in touch with Sydney. There we go. Love it. Hey, guys.
Hi.
Sydney is 4. And her wish was to also go to Walt Disney World. And you heard her say in the video too, she wanted to meet a unicorn. Did you end up meeting a unicorn, Sydney?
Not yet.
Not yet. Maybe that day is still coming. Who did you see when you were in Walt Disney World?
I saw Ariel.
Oh, is she your favorite?
Yes.
Love it. That sounds like so much fun. And Mom, Melinda, from a mom's perspective, how do you
feel about her?
This kind of affected Sydney. Did you notice a total difference after going down there and being able to, you know, get away for a little and have fun as a family together? All right, it looks like they might have froze on us. Maybe we can try and get back to Sydney in a couple of minutes. That's a bummer, but that's okay. This could happen. All right, we're gonna, we'll jump over to Aubrey right now. See if Sydney comes back up, we'll get back to her because it looks like it's still frozen. All right, Aubrey. Aubrey, as soon as I saw your wish. Oh, Sydney's back now. Things go. It's 2020. Anything could happen. And now we're doing everything over the internet. All right. I think we can hear you guys. Can you hear us, Sydney?
So-so.
A little so-so.
Okay.
It's going so-so. In and out.
Okay. Melinda, we just wanted to hear from you. How was the wish for you guys from a parent's perspective?
For us, it was definitely a celebration because we had had, you know, we've been separated. And to put it behind us and look at it in the rear view and just celebrate mm-hmm. and have fun together. Not worry about anything, you know, for one, you know, when you're going through treatments and your counts are low, you can't be around other people. Just what we're going through right now with this pandemic.
Yeah. Yeah, I bet.
out thank in you. Disney World and
all right. That's for unfortunately, sure. She's cutting in and out there, but you kind of get the gist of it. It was obviously really nice for the family to get away. And I'm sure for Sydney, it was just the time of her life getting down there and going to Walt Disney World and meeting Ariel. Let's jump over to Aubrey now. Aubrey is 14. Her wish was to go to Paris Fashion Week. Which, oh my goodness, I am so jealous and I can't wait to hear how this was. Tell me everything, Aubrey. How was it?
It was definitely amazing. It was awesome to see the fashion shows in the Eiffel Tower in the Louvre. I can't pronounce that correctly.
The Louvre.
And it was awesome to be able to do it with family.
So are you like really into fashion? Is that something that you see yourself wanting to do one day? What made you want to go there?
I have always been interested in fashion. I've always been a fashionista, as we like to call it, from since I was little. And I have a huge interest in design, and that's where it kind of came from. And seeing the shows just made me even more ambitious to achieve what I want, my dreams.
Girl, we got a lot in common. I'm a fashionista too. Did you meet any cool designers, or what shows did you go to?
I got to see Dior, Off-White, Yohei Yamamoto. The list goes on. It was amazing.
That is so cool.
Wow. Yeah.
So what was your favorite part?
I've thought about this several times and I don't think I can pick a favorite, but one of like a really shocking moment for me was seeing it, the Eiffel Tower sparkle at night.
Wow. You know, it was a good trip when you can't think of what the best moment.
Yeah.
I love that. That is awesome. So cool to hear about that wish. All right. We're moving on to Lainey and Jaden, and Chad, back to you.
Hold, I got that. Hold on. And Lainey, I talked to Lainey earlier, so we know hers. Jaden isn't here. I think we're all good. I think we got all. Yes, we're all good right now.
Oh, that was my fault there. Sorry about that.
All good. As you can see, we have a wonderful array of wishes, from everything from meeting the Red Sox, the Steelers, to Walt Disney World. It's just amazing that we're able to do these for kids. And I'm just proud to be a part of it. And I thank each and every one of you for sharing your wishes with us and being a part of this 2020 version. And here we are, Bill Trigg.
Sorry. Thanks for being part of this, Chad and Alyssa. Know that we, you know, this campaign kickoff would not be the same without both of you. So thank you to all of our ambassadors. I love hearing your stories. I love the opportunity to meet some of you. Aubrey, one of my very favorite pictures of you is when you're in that one big hall and there's a lot of these famous photographers behind you and you're right there in front, you know, taking pictures right in front of them. I just thought that was so cool. Especially to our Wish ambassadors, I mean, these are our stars here tonight, and the more than 1,950 Wish kids that they represent, whose wishes have been granted since 1987. Before I declare the Adopt a Wish holiday campaign as being officially underway, we would like to ask all of you to go to our website right after this kickoff ends and consider a donation to make wishes come true. Because remember, as you've heard our Wish kids say, wishes are waiting and hope is essential, especially at this time. So please donate today. Go to aawc.givesmart.com to purchase stars, to check out our special raffles that we have as part of the campaign this year, and to also make a donation. Now, Chad, I heard that we're joining you for a very special on-air moment.
You can't tell by the video of what's going to be happening, can you, Bill?
Well, everyone,
Ambassadors, you know what we're going to do?
Stay tuned.
All right, if everybody's ready, B95.5, today's hits and yesterday's favorites. It's the time of year to fill your radio with cheer. We are so blessed to be a part of the B95.5. We are so blessed to be a part of the Adopt-A-Wish campaign, 28th annual. Congratulations to Bill Trigg and his staff, 28th annual Adopt-A-Wish campaign, which is kicking off as I speak. And I'm literally on a virtual party right now. As you're listening to me on B95.5, we're on a virtual party for the Make-A-Wish Foundation of Northeast New York. The Adopt-A-Wish campaign has kicked off, and we are encouraging you, because there are children with critical illnesses locally that need a wish to come true. We're asking for your support this year to buy a star. And you can buy a star right now at aawc.givesmart.com. That's aawc.givesmart.com. And remember, you can stop by area malls right up through the end of the year to purchase your wish stars for our ambassadors. And also you can stop by our presenting sponsor, Trusco. Stop by any of their locations to get your wish star, and we encourage you to do so. But this is a very special time for us, because not only are we a part of the kickoff campaign for the Adopt-A-Wish campaign, it's time for B95.5 to kick off the celebration for the entire capital region. Now, Home for the Holidays will have a very true meaning this year, but we promise we will brighten up your holidays with the joy, the fun, the magic of Christmas, with each and every song bringing out the memories for you to enjoy, and we'll create memories as best as we can this year with your help. But right now, it's time for us to flip the switch. With the flip of a wish, Bill, as we say each and every year, we turn B95.5 into the official Christmas music station of the entire Capital Region. So I need the entire Capital Region right now who's listening. And of course, our wish ambassadors, are you ready? Our wish families, are you ready?
Yeah. Ready.
Make-A-Wish Foundation of Northeast New York, are you ready? Trust Yes. Bank, are you ready? Alyssa Carapries, I know you're ready, from CBS 6 News.
And I'm ready.
Listening right now, you are our gift, and we are going to give you the sounds of the season right now. Everybody, let's count from 10 to 1. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, Two, one. Now be safe, be healthy, be happy, be merry. B95.5, the Christmas music station. Turn it up, John. There we go. Happy holidays, Merry Christmas. Ready? You gotta dance. You too, Evan.
Thanks and good night, everybody. Have a great holiday season. And
you thank too. You for your support. Happy holidays, everybody. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Be safe and be happy, everybody.
All right. All our love to our wish families.